Hello, welcome to Not Talking Virgo. Good morning, good night, and good afternoon, wherever you are. Today, I'm gonna go through some films that crushes have done, and I wanna see their recent projects, like what they've been up to and what films they've produced. So my first childhood celebrity crush is Chad Michael Murray. You might recognize him from House of Wax, A Cinderella Story, and Freaky Friday, of course. So I want to see what kind of projects he's been up to lately, what films has he done lately, and kind of give my review of his last film. And his last film was a film called Fortress, A Sniper's Eye, and I believe it's a sequel to a movie called Fortress. I never heard of these two films, and apparently they're going to make a third one. So I want to reveal the sequel, and then maybe later on I could review the first one. But I just want to see the second one since it's his latest film, and it's a sequel. Maybe you don't need much of a backstory. Maybe they'll just get right to it. So I'll review that. And yeah, and I'm sorry if my speech is all crazy. Like, I'm not, this is totally unscripted, and you're gonna see me stutter a lot and talking in rambles, but come on. Who doesn't like YouTubers that talk like that? Come on, like, give me your authentic self, right? I'll try to do the best I can with my editing, but honestly, this is that Virgo talking. I remember being a child and being like, damn, Chad, you are so damn fine. And I will leave, I'll tell you guys how I felt about the film. And I'll put my favorite clip of the movie too. And that's my first celebrity crush. And so I'm going to go watch the movie now. And I will go on to my second one. So what did I think about Fortress's Sniper's Eye? 1 through 10, I'll give it a 3. You know, 8 minutes into the movie, Chad Michael Murray dies. And I thought, oh, maybe this happened in the first one because it kind of came through like a flashback. And so the beginning of the movie was kind of not that good. It was just Bruce Willis basically laying down on the bed and like the other characters of the film congratulating him that he had murdered Chad Michael Murray's character. I guess Chad Michael Murray is the enemy of Brad Willis. I'm not sure. They're like at a weird camp. You definitely had to see the first one to understand the sequel. And so 40 minutes into the movie, Chad Michael Murray's character comes back. And that's when the movie starts picking up, but 40 minutes into the movie. I only stayed to watch the rest of the film because Jesse McAuliffe was in it, the guy from John Tucker Must Die. Great actor. And so he looks totally different. He has a beard. He's like golden brown, like he got a good tan. He looks really bomb. And so I was like, okay, I'll just stay to watch him. But then Chad Michael Murray's character comes back. And I guess he never died or something. And one of the enemies along with, like on Chad Michael Murray's side, he didn't die either. I don't know what was going on. I guess they pretended that they died or something. But yeah, the movie was really not that good. Like, I swear to God, for 40 minutes, people were just congratulating Bruce Willis. Like, thank you for killing that guy. He was so evil, blah, blah, blah. And the ending, I guess, gets a little bit action-packed, but it's really not good at all. Maybe the first one was good, though. I have not seen the first one, so probably the first one was worth a watch. And so, yeah. And so, that being said, was it worth my time? Really not. But look, Chad Michael Murray, he's doing movies with Bruce Willis, so that's good. That's what he's up to, and maybe he'll be in more different films after this franchise.
Check his quarters. Well, Robert, why am I not surprised to hear your voice?
Let everyone go. We can work something out.
I tried that.
First time you stole $600 million from me. Second time you shot me and left me for dead. I'm beginning to think I can't trust you, Robert.
So we'll get on to my next celebrity crush, childhood celebrity crush. So my second celebrity childhood celebrity crush is Mike Vitar, the guy from Sandlot, and the main character from Sandlot. And according to IMDb, his last film is, he only did 9 films, by the way. I was kind of surprised. His last film was The Mighty Ducks, D3. So I actually have Disney Plus, so I'll be watching that and reviewing it. Let's see if I'll like it. I like Sandlot for what it is, so hopefully it's kind of like Sandlot, like a little bit funny and sportsy. I don't really like sport films, but Sandlot, come on, everybody loves Sandlot. So I'll review that and let you know what I thought about it. Soon. D3, The Mighty Ducks. So the movie was very good. I actually loved it more than Chad Michael Murray's latest film. I love that, actually, it didn't show Mike Vitar a lot. You only see glimpses of him, and he didn't talk much, so I'm not sure how much he got paid, but I'm sure it's nothing close to what he got in the movie Sandlot. But the movie was still really good. I love that, like, it takes you through an emotional roller coaster, honestly. Like, at first, the coach is threatening them, like, you guys better play good or else you guys are going to get kicked out. And so, or, like, he basically said walk or play better. And so, two of them, they freaking walk. And then all of, out of nowhere, the board member was like, no, I'm going to take out the whole team. None of you guys can play because you guys aren't playing right. That's it. You guys are just not playing good. Y'all need to get your shit together. And the poor team of teenagers, they're like, what? We are trying to play good, you know? And, like, here Emilio Estevez comes out of nowhere and, like, all of a sudden he has a major, bigger part. He's showing up more towards the end. And I'm, like, thinking, I'm, like, looking at him, and I'm, like, dude, this guy does look like Charlie Sheen. He got the stature of Charlie Sheen, and he looks like Martin Sheen, too. Like, they're all related. Like, if I was at a dinner party with them, I'd be like, yep, they're definitely related. But, yeah, the movie is really good. I'll insert my favorite scenes from the movie, but Mike Vitar didn't really show up. But it was still a really good movie. I preferred it. Other than Fortress, so Sniper's Eye. Also, The Mighty Ducks, I would give it a 9. Because it was very childlike, but it was kind of funny. And I don't know, I think most child movies I really can't watch anymore because my brain starts to zone out. But this movie was alright. Like, I liked it. It was kind of corny and funny. I loved Keon Thompson's character and a character called Goldsberg that was super funny, and Coach Orion, I like his character too. He's pretty funny, even though he kind of is harsh on the kids, like play better. But yeah, it was a good film.
Come on, let me see. Don't take me down.
Careful, man, they don't call him Brazilian fire ants for nothing.
You think he's gonna notice him missing?
I don't think he keeps a head count, Charlie.
Hey, you a stray calf?
What the?
It'd be more fun for me if you ran.
Get you now! You are dead, man! Dead, you hear me? Thank you!
It's an interest that really makes you look, I don't know how you say,
Ruggedly handsome?
Amazingly stupid.
Very funny. Let's get up.
All right, no. Here it is, your funnel.
100.
Release the hungry fellows.
Drop them in there.
And on to my third celebrity childhood crush. It is Benjamin Bratt from Catwoman. And Blood In and Blood Out. Dead for a Dollar. Benjamin Bratt in Dead for a Dollar. I will be reviewing that and putting my favorite scenes in the end of my review. So I just finished watching. Well, actually, I didn't finish watching. I just attempted to watch Benjamin Bratt's latest film called, I just told you guys, but I was trying to watch it and it did not catch my attention. It's a Western thriller. And I just wanted to see if you guys want to watch a Western film. It's not a thriller, but it was a great Western film and it's a comedy. It's called Casa de Mi Padre. Oh my god, that movie is hilarious. I will insert some clips of that one, but I'm sorry. But this movie, oh, it's called Dead for a Dollar. It's not, I don't know, it's not my cup of tea. Maybe people who love Western films will love this one, but I don't know. It's just a bit boring to me, and I kept zoning out. I couldn't watch it, but I would definitely show you guys Casa de Mi Padre, starring Will Ferrell. He speaks Spanish throughout the whole movie. It's like super hilarious. But yeah, I couldn't finish this one.
Pero solo quiero saber dónde has estado. Estábamos pastoreando el ganado. Como usted me dijo, aquí te tardaste tanto. Hay muchas cosas que hacer aquí, Armando. ¿Hace algo? Déjale pues. Armando. Sí, padre. Ven, Armando. Discúlpame. Es que eres igual a tu mamá. Tu madre es una buena persona y tú también eres una muy buena persona. Tu madre no era muy lista y tú tampoco eres muy listo. Pero sí soy listo.
Claro, sí, Armando.
Pero para lo que estoy haciendo necesito alguien bien listo. Y si tú fueras listo, te darías cuenta que eres tonto. Mira, la cabeza frigorda. ¡Raúl! ¡Es Raúl! ¡Es Raúl!
I hope you guys enjoyed this video that I just created. Recap, we've seen three films. Well, I've seen three films and reviewed them. Of my childhood favorite crushes and of their latest films that they've produced or written. And yep. Stay tuned for some more videos. I will be posting nearly every day probably. I don't got a job, I don't got school, I ain't got shit to do, so you'll be seeing more of my face on YouTube. I don't want to do reviews all the time, but I'll see, I don't know, maybe that'll be the main theme of my channel, and hopefully we could have a good time just talking about these movies or the shows I'm watching, and yeah. See you next time, bye.